Please join me to welcome Mr. Vernon to be one of the first panelists to come to the stage. Next, Mr. Michael Song.
Personalization, understanding and looking at things from a more personal perspective. Interpersonal skills, I think, are essential to successful organizations and are essential to successful leaders. So I would look to people aspiring to be leaders to continue to increase their capabilities of interpersonal communication and building stronger relationships, listening more, and probably trying to control things less.
So with that said, and anyone can jump in, do you think there's a new definition of an IT project manager, so to speak, minus the manager word? Is there a new definition of who they are? What defines their role at this point in time? Again, this is the easy part, right? So from my perspective, the technology we're trying to add is trying to reduce the headache of management. And so I really like your sentiment that the people will be involved more with people. There's more about an empowering aspect of leading and helping people to do more things with less management and actually contributing on a value add. And that's what our technology can do to save that time, make sure management easier and do it achieve something. Michael, yeah.
I guess my first entry point was let's review what PMI board has to offer. I think communication is outdated in a sense. It's a very outdated term because communication always implies that you transmit something either one-to-one or through a mechanism. I think the modern world is much more complex in the sense that interaction management is perhaps more critical than just pure communication. An average IT manager today, I would say your eyeball to eyeball, your FaceTime with other individuals certainly would occupy 80% of the time. When I was working, running a very large, a software engineering group, I find that most of my time, my working time is actually meeting people. That's what it is. I thought interaction skills and competency in holding conversations, being able to identify intelligent past failures as well as intelligent past success, I think that becomes very important.
Can I ask a question?
Sure, go
ahead. Well, this more towards computing. At the beginning of this year, when I start to so-called introduce the concept of cloud computing to this MSCPM Circle community, I use the word disruptive technology. I see that if cloud computing can really take place and happen in a big way, and some of you here, your company are involved in selling storage security solutions, you probably will be eliminated. What is AWS position in this?
Thanks, Oscar.
Of
course, we're not out to eliminate anyone. We're just trying to add value to the customer. Our focus is trying to add value there. But I think, yes, it is a disruptive technology. It's hopefully not disruptive in that it's going to change everything, but it will leave in its wake some companies and technologies that are not there, but the essence of agile, the agility of being able to move into different projects and different technologies very quickly, I think that's the real benefit that most will take advantage of. So it's important for all companies to realize that if they can't adapt very quickly, if they can't change very quickly, sure, there might be some casualties there.
Do I still have my job?
I'd like to just follow up on that, because my response to your question is, those are opportunities. If you're not burdened with many of the things that cloud computing can take away, yeah, then you can move into a leadership position. Do something that is new and innovative with that technology. Agility is far beyond just the idea of process agility. Agility is a personal thing. If you really want to be agile, you should be looking at retooling yourself continuously. I think that cloud computing just presents us with more opportunity to move away from some things that truly have occupied our time without providing great value. If we want to maximize value, yeah, there's some opportunity to exercise some personal agility.
At this point, I'll probably stop for anyone except SK to ask a question. I saw a couple of people who were stirring earlier on in the presentation. If you're still around, perhaps this is a good time to ask your question. Can we begin the Amazon magic box, and is there another book to give away, maybe, that's incentivized? Anyone? Yes, please.
Hi. I'm a project manager for a company that provides package solutions as well as turnkey solutions for custom development. I mean, judging from the talk today, it looks as if there is a lot of work that is done in the custom development area, where people are writing programs in clouds and serving to the public and all that. But on the other end, we see Oracle buying up every company in the landscape. There's literally three big companies now in the IT industry. What do you think you see as the next generation?
Are we doing more? Are we doing more custom development software or package software?
My question is, do you see us doing more custom development software or doing more package implementations? Thank you.
Interesting question. I'll take guidance from someone who moves here. Krishnamurti wrote a very interesting article that, and they introduced the term customerization, right? In other words, we're talking about mass customization, the ability to customize every individual experience. And that's a trend that's growing very fast, and it's occupying a huge space to the others. So from my perspective, I would certainly not discounting package solutions, because every solution has its own differentiated customer. So, you know, it's always process for process. So, but certainly customization, in the scheme of things, I think would be an area to has greater potential to grow.
Does anyone else want to take that? I'll just add some insights on that as well. The interesting thing about custom application development, we've seen that actually rise quite prominently over in the ASEAN region, quite significantly at this point. There are probably two areas here to address. One is the problem with a lot of those on-premise license-based turnkey solution type vendors at this point, who are trying to actually capitalize on cloud computing, for example, is that they cannot figure out the best model to do so. I've actually interacted with a financial applications company who decided that they were giving on-premise license, and the next year they just went fully on the cloud. They just almost closed down, to be absolutely honest, because that's not the right way. It's not an either or. So a lot of the times that, I like to give the analogy, if Microsoft actually stopped giving on-premise license for Microsoft Office, for example, they'll be in a lot of trouble as well. So there's a little bit of a hybrid to actually strike there. The second trend we're actually noticing over here in ASEAN is that a lot of traditional sectors are actually demanding for something more specific to their vertical, very verticalized solutions, which is putting at risk very off-the-shelf applications actually at this point, putting a lot of risk there in terms of trying to actually ship out to these guys. So we're seeing a lot of trends for like manufacturing, looking for very specific manufacturing-based applications. You look at oil and gas, it's very oil and gas-centric type things. Our survey came back when we sent out a very plain survey saying that cloud computing, what would you actually get on? Would it be a very typical ERP? Would it be a very typical CRM? No one actually ticked those boxes. They actually went with other, and they actually wrote specifically what they want within the organization. Very business analytics, very BPM focus as well, to manufacturing. So that's why there's quite a rise actually in custom application development at this point. I hope I could address a bit of that there. Anyone else? No? I'll open it up begin because I think, how much time do we have left? Oh, nice big thing, 5 minutes? Yes, sir.
Hi, good afternoon. My name is Neil. I am a project manager of Dell. I guess this question is directed towards statistically good. I'm very excited and by the presentation earlier about cloud computing and all that. Today, I'm a project manager in Dell. I'm very happy assisting customers such as banks. You know, we have a 3-year hardware upgrade exercise, example, you know. Every 2 years, you help customers to upgrade their mainframes, their servers, and so on. And they continue buying storage and all the jazz. But what is disturbing is that if the banks are here today and saw your presentation and was very attracted to your, I can't remember, 25 cents that you could buy or something. So, you know, if the banks suddenly tomorrow decide to outsource to Amazon, what happens to me? So my question is, to be fair to you as well, Mr. Kingsley,
Do you
possibly see a shift? I'm just guessing, I'm just anticipating. Do you possibly see a shift of project managers
changing organizations?
Do you foresee, like, today maybe project managers are working for banks or Dell, but in the future project managers
have to, start sending resumes to data centers like yourself? Has anyone done any studies of where project management skills are really required?
Thank you. We are hiring. No, seriously, I think Vernon had your immediate response, which is quite right. It requires traditional companies to think, well, instead of selling direct to specialized individual customers, maybe they would entertain moving those technologies to ways to selling to cloud providers. Right? That's just another avenue for the same. We still need the hardware. The hardware is still required, right? We're not getting rid of computers just yet. Right? So there will always be a need for specialized use cases. And the example of the financial services industry is exactly right. I mean, there are companies and organizations and verticals where specialized on-premise, we know we've got the flashing lights under our desk, that kind of mentality, that won't be going away anytime soon. Right? We're talking about the bulk shift of most of those IT needs moving to the cloud. So I think there will always be a market for specialized requirements like that. And yes, there will be a shift in the industry. There'll be an evolution of skills moving around. I don't think those skills are going away. You know, again, I don't want to make the message that cloud computing is a threat to the IT management staff. It's not. It's an empowerment, right? And again, to Vernon's point, you put it exactly right. If you can be agile enough to be reinventing it, your skills, thinking how can I apply what I already know and adapting them to modern technology, you can be more powerful, more productive in your role. And again, we are hiring, so.
Exactly right. So they're putting that skill sets you already have and they're trying to figure out how to project manage a mobile team, a geographically disparate team, and all those different instances instead. We can probably take one more question before we have to close it up with the little cards there. Maybe. Any other questions that we could take? One more? Are we good? There? If that's the case, then perhaps we can start from Michael all the way across to Vernon in terms of your final thoughts for, I'm going to use the term aspiring leaders. Evolving out of your current role, moving forward with technology and the economy and the competitiveness out there. Do you have any pearls of wisdom to share with these folks?
If you're just talking about project management, management, and you can actually broaden that concept to management in general. You can also, you know, touch towards or even encroach on leadership. I think because I'm talking about Black Swan today, right? I was kind of perhaps use part of Black Swan's thinking when it comes to these kind of issues. The project manager today, the manager today, must not, if you like, operate in isolation. I have seen sufficient evidence that a lot of people, a lot of management, certainly operates in what we describe under Black Swan as micro certainty. You're so certain about your micro area, right? And yet at the same time, the world is getting more dynamic, more complex. You cannot lose sight of what we term as macro uncertainty. There's a lot of uncertainty at the macro level, right? You can never answer all the difficulties or the challenges, but at least as a modern leader, you have to be aware the interrelationship between the macro and the micro level. So the question therefore is, if you want to be an adaptable and agile manager, whether project leaders, it requires you to have a more integrated perspective about the world, about the dynamism in the world, and embrace that there are some things that you may not be able to conceive or perceive, but at the same time, be prepared.
Discussion. Let's give them a round of applause.